With doubtnet, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question and get instant video solution. Download doubtnet app today.
Hello everyone, let's start the question. The question says that identify the non-feasible reaction. So here in this question, we are provided with four options in which we have four reactions given, among which we have to look for the reaction which will be not feasible. Means it will not be proceeding in the way it is written. So in order to check for the feasibility, we have to check for the reactant side and for the product side, and then we will check if this particular reaction will proceed or not. Will it be possible to proceed with this reaction or not? So let us now start the solution to our question. If we talk of the first reaction, if we write here, we are given with acetylene as the reactant, that is CH3, single bond C, triple bond CH, and it is reacting with NH2-. Then on the product side, we have CH3, C triple bond 3- plus NH3. Now, here this is acetylene, and on the product side we have acetylide ion. So what happens is, if we check for this acetylene, it liberates the proton, that is H proton, and this is a NH2- is a strong base. NH2- is a strong base, acetylene liberates the proton, and this particular acetylide ion, this negative charge on the ion gets stabilized. This is a stabilized anion. So yes, we can say that this particular reaction is feasible. So this is definitely not our answer, because we have to check for the reaction which will not be feasible, which is not feasible. In a similar manner, let us see with the reaction given in second option. Here we have CH3, CH2OH is reacting with NaH, and then on the product side we have CH3, CH2ONa plus H2. And if we write the third reaction also, because both of them have a similar explanation, so let me write that also. This third reaction, which is CH3OH. Why 2 and 3 we are writing together? Because here also we have an alcohol, and here also we have alcohol present. In second we have ethanol, this is ethanol, and in third we have methanol. So they are going to have a similar sort of explanation. Let us see. Methanol is reacting with NaOH in the third reaction, and on the product side, what we have is, we have CH3ONa plus H2. In the question, it is giving H2O. So now, what happens is, in 2 and 3, we have sodium compounds involved. Let me write here, in reaction 2 and 3, we have the involvement of sodium compounds are involved in these reactions, and what will happen is, on reaction with alcohol, they have the tendency. Who has the tendency? Sodium compounds. On reaction with alcohol, let me write here, they have the tendency, sodium compounds have tendency to readily liberate hydrogen, that is H2 gas, on reaction with alcohol. So both these reactions, reaction 2 and reaction 3, are what? Feasible. They are feasible reactions. So now we are left with just our last reaction, that is reaction 4, if I write the reaction. Here we have CH, triple bond CH, it is reacting with NaOH, and the product side we have CH triple bond CNa plus H2O. So now in this case, if we check carefully, this one is a weak acid. The reactant is a weak acid, CH triple bond CH. And if we check for this NaOH, we know it is a very, we can say, strong base. It is a strong base. So this particular reaction is not feasible because this acid cannot react with this NaOH. So this is a not feasible reaction, also the answer to our question. So we have to look for the reaction which is not feasible. So we can write our final answer as option 4. Option 4 is not feasible. This is our final answer to the question. This was all about our question. Thank you.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level, trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download Doubt and App today.